Okay, so welcome to Bentley Systems Southeast Asia. And for this video, I'm going to walk you through to ORD or OpenRoads Designer Singapore dataset. Now, before anything else, there's a question: what is Singapore dataset in OpenRoads Designer software? Okay, basically, the very simple answer is Singapore dataset is a repository or a container of Singapore standard based on LTA's SDRE and civil design criteria and CP83 or code of practice 83. Okay, but how can we be able to confirm is Singapore standard and context were part of its content? So first thing, make sure that you have already downloaded and installed the Singapore dataset. If you haven't done it yet, please take a look at the link from the description below. But if you have already done so, you can join me in navigating the Singapore dataset context. Okay, now what are we expecting and what are we looking for with the Singapore dataset? So I'm going to open up my OpenRoads Designer Connect Edition, and from here, on the workspace section, choose the Singapore standards and select any work set according to your project. Okay, that is very, very important. All right, now you open up your file or create a new file. Okay, so what I have here is I open up a project. It's an existing project that I'm working on, and what I'm going to show you first is feature definition toolbar and the standard toolbar. So over here at the upper section on my interface, okay, let me just click on that. And if you don't have this design standard toolbar, and if you don't have the feature definition toolbar, you can go to the geometry tab, and then from the general tools or general groups of tools, click on the standards and drop that down. You will see this menu here. Select the design standard toolbar, and then the other one is the feature definition toolbar. Okay, now you can place it anywhere you want according to your user preference. Okay, all right, so the first one here is to show you civil design criteria, which is you can basically see it from the design standard toolbar, and click on that arrow and then scroll down, and then you can see the Singapore road design. Okay, you can expand that folder structure, and then you can see the speed limits. You can choose one of them, say for example 90 kilometers per hour, and then you can see both horizontal and vertical requirements. Okay, so over here you can see the site distance, stopping site distance design criteria, and over here is your speed limit design criteria. Okay, the next item is the CP83 or code of practice. Okay, how can we be able to tell if CP83 is included in the Singapore standard? Okay, so now you can go to the home tab, and then from the primary group, you click on the level manager. Okay, you click on that, and then here you can be able to see the naming convention as well, and then its colored assignments, and then the line style assignments, as well as the line weights assignments. Okay, and that is the code of practice or CP83 levels. And the other one is the color table. I'm gonna go and take a look at the color table and check, take a look at the information. Okay, now it will tell you it is LTA.tbl or table. All right, I'm gonna go and close that. So the next one is the geo-coordinate system. So to check if the geo-coordinate system is part of the Singapore standard, what you will do is go to the utilities tab. Okay, and under the utilities tab, you can see that there is a geographic group, and click on the coordinate system. Alright, when you click on the coordinate system, you can see that there is an SVY21. So that's one way of confirming that you have your SVY21 incorporated in your Singapore data set. Now, the other one is go to the upper left portion of your working window. Okay, click on the view attributes. And then you can see here at the background map section, at the lower portion of this view attributes window, you can see the background map type. Click on that, and then you will see, or you will select the display options, street map, aerial, or hybrid. So let's take a look at the aerial, and then close this view attributes, and when wait for the map to load. Okay, and then you can see that it is located in Singapore. All right. Okay, now you can be able to turn off your background map and back to your model. Okay. Now, the second item is the templates. Okay, so the templates is based on SDRE, or standard details of road elements. All right, so you may go to the corridors tab. Okay, there you go. And select the template right there, the create template, click it off, and then it will open the create template editor window. And then there you go. So over here at this section, click on the templates folder, double click on to expand the folder structure, and select the LTA SG road, double click on that. Here you can be able to see all the standard template to be used for a Singapore road project. Okay, so you can see here, 4 lanes, 2 lanes, key to a curb, type 1 pavement, okay, and all that. Okay, so the next items is the linear feature element. Okay, so the linear feature element are those alignments, the road lane markings, the edge of pavement or edge of the road, or the curb elements, or railings, or the vehicular guard rails, or VIGs. Okay, so here in the model, in the 2D view, you can see that there is a an alignment over here. You can take a look at the property. So it says SD geometry baseline, and you can name the alignment according to your project. So along with the alignment comes with the annotation group, which you can be able to annotate it with your chainage. Okay, so as you can see right here, there's a chainage value, there's a coordinate of your alignment element. Okay, and then the other one is the road lane markings, which you can see over here. So those road lane markings are basically our smart element as well, so you can be able to still change those offset value or the placement value. Say for example, this one you want to increase that to a 5, so it will change on the 3D model as well as on your 2D view. Okay, so let's return it back to its original form, so including those road arrow markings. Okay, so all of that is based on the feature definition. So you can see here that the feature definition, the name of that feature is Singapore LTA Lane Marking Type C. Okay, and then over here at your the arrow marking, you can basically see SG LTA Lane Marking Arrow Right Turn. Okay, all of that with its appropriate naming convention, or the logical naming convention. So you can see over here, solid marking. Take a look at the properties. So it says type G. Okay, as well as this pedestrian lane, which is type A8. Those are the linear features for the alignment and road marking. So along with it is basically the railings. The railings has its 2D symbology as well as 3D symbology as well. So as you can see right here, okay, so when you create a railing such as this one here, So say for example, I'm gonna go to the geometry tab. I'm gonna create the same railing as that. Okay, so perhaps using this line here. So I'm gonna create a railing over at this one here, from here to here. Okay, so you'll be able to see that I can be able to create a railing with a different symbology. From 2D, you have line style, and on a 3D is the what we are expecting on the real project scenario. Okay, so I'm gonna go and delete that. All right, so along with the railing, we have the vehicular guardrail. So the same as the railing, you can see this one here is the vehicular guardrail symbology. So this one is a single W beam, or a single sided as well, and it is in the left portion. So the location of that is over here. Okay, so you can see that there's a guardrail right there. Okay, so the same case of how you can be able to place your type railings and the guardrail. Okay, so the next items is point features. Okay, the point features is where we can place our traffic lights and traffic signages. Okay, so we have right here in the plan view, we have traffic signage, and we have the traffic light. Okay, so on the 3D preview as well, you can see that you have the signages right here, and then as well as those traffic lights, and even we have the pedestrian those flashing beacon. Okay, and right here you have the half mast traffic light. All right, so say for example this one over here at the 2D view, and we know that this location here is over at this portion. Okay, so let's see, let me just go through on that portion. So if I go and delete that, okay, then it will be deleted, and then I'm gonna go and delete that as well. Okay, so it will be deleted as well. Now if we go and try to place the traffic light, then we go here the horizontal groups of tools, and then go to the point. Okay, click on the point. Okay, so there. All right, so one more here. If you want to place a tactile over here, you can use the single offset partial. Okay, so now I have the tactile. You can take a look on my plan view, and then you can also check on my 3D preview. Okay, so that is how you can be able to place or use the point features. And of course, the user can still be able to add more feature based of the project requirements, as well as based from CP83 and SDRE. Okay, so thank you, and please hit the like and subscribe button for more tutorial videos, and I will see you next time.